There's a popular way of personal growth among more spiritual, heart-centered people. And that popular way is to try to clear limiting beliefs. Now, I have a controversial opinion about that, which is that limiting beliefs, if you try to clear them, will tend to multiply because anything you give your attention to becomes stronger. Anything you try to fight, especially if it's intangible, will tend to become stronger and you empower that which you fight. Interesting, right? Now, this may not be true in the physical world. You pummel something physically and it seems to degrade and die. But when it comes to intangible enemies, beliefs, fears, any other intangible enemy, you try to fight it and it gets stronger. So beware of trying to clear limiting beliefs. Now, even though I don't believe in limiting beliefs, I believe and I see in the evidence of people that I work with or colleagues or whatever, I mean, people who are seeking my help, I see limiting structures. So let me tell you about some of the limiting structures, because the thing is this. You can change, for sure. You can change the structures of your life, and the structures will then transform you as a person, and make you, reach your goals and follow, reach your dreams and all that stuff, right? So, a couple of limiting structures. One, saying yes easily to too many requests and opportunities. So anything people say, "Oh, I need your help." Okay, great, I'll help you. A message comes through. Oh, I might respond to that message. Yes. If a message comes through, you don't necessarily have to respond to it. You can ignore it. You are allowed to ignore messages, whether it's a Facebook message or an email inbox message or a text message. You can ignore it. Did anyone not give you that permission? Give yourself that permission to ignore other people's messages. That's a request, and that's an opportunity. Now, I'm not saying you should ignore all messages, but what I'm saying is if you're watching this, you are probably, being in my audience, you're probably a heart-centered person. You're a very kind person, very generous person. You're a giver. So you tend to feel all this obligation to reply to everybody, to always comment on everything and et cetera, right? Which is why in the past couple of months, I have stopped replying to most of your comments, and I apologize for that. But at least I try to, I read everything. I read everything at the very least. But so beware of saying yes and what you're saying yes to. You don't have to say yes to other people's stuff. Because the more, think about this, think of this way. The more you say yes, okay, the more you say yes to other people's requests and opportunities, the more you are letting them put structure into your life. And the more you learn to say no or just not say yes, the more freedom you have to generate, self-generate your structures. Okay, so that's one, is limiting structure of saying, a habit of saying yes to everything. Okay, second limiting structure is not having a stable schedule. And not having a stable schedule will not allow you to have consistent actions in your business that grow your business. If you have a business and if you're asking me to invest and you don't have a stable schedule and consistent actions, I would not invest. I mean, just as a sense of, I wouldn't bet on a business that doesn't have a stable schedule. Because it's just, I mean, what kind of company doesn't have a stable schedule, right? They want their employees to have a stable schedule, right? Because then they can predict what's going to get done when and things will be delivered on time, et cetera. But what about your own business? If you don't have a stable schedule, you're like a company that can't be predictable. Oh, I don't know if they're going to create their deliver their product on time. I don't know, because they don't have a stable schedule, right? So that's a big, big limiting structure that people have in their lives, is the lack of a stable structure, a stable schedule. And the reason why people don't have stable schedules is they're like blown about by the wind. Someone sends them a message. Oh, now they're in that person's structure. Now they're in that person's thread. Someone requests something. They have external demands. They follow external demands too easily, and they follow internal whims too easily. Oh, I feel like doing this right now. I'm gonna go do it because I'm a free spirit, and I go do whatever. It's fine to be a free spirit, as long as you don't need to make any money, as long as you don't have any obligations in life, you don't need to pay taxes or whatever. Be a free spirit, all you want. But we are given this life as a structure. You are born, and then you have a certain number of years, and then you die. You have a deadline, a blessed deadline called death. You know, and the seasons are a deadline. The seasons are very stable. Nature is very stable. Have you noticed? Nature has a very stable schedule. That should give us a clue that life wants us to have a stable schedule. If we want to have, you know, consistent growth and development and evolution, right? So beware of how quickly you're drawn by external demands and messages and internal whims. Oh, I want to do this. I want to do that. No. I've scheduled to do this right now. I scheduled to make this video for you. So I'm making this video for you. I'm not going to say, well, I don't feel like making this video right now, because I didn't. Trust me. Sorry to say, but I didn't feel like making this video right now. Okay, but here I am, and now that I'm making it, I'm enjoying myself more. And that's the third limiting structure I want to talk about, which is a habit of avoiding creative discomfort. Big, big limiting structure. People think, I want to write, I want to make videos, I want to create a successful business, I want to create whatever you want to create, any project, any mission, any cause. Okay, you want to create it. Great, wonderful. Did you know that if you want to create something successfully, you will have to face creative discomfort again and again and again and again and again and again, again and again. And it never, by the way, it never goes away. I'm sorry to say, even the greatest writers, the greatest movie directors, the greatest business people, the greatest artists all tell us that the fear never goes away. The concern that it's not going to be good, the self-doubt never goes away. I'm sorry, but it never goes away. So how do people like me deal with it? I understand that there is creative discomfort in the beginning. And then if you allow yourself to keep working in spite of that creative discomfort, for example, when I was writing the blog post for this video, which I'll post later when I'm finished writing it, I was a blank screen. I mean, God, the blank screen, I only have one idea. The idea was, okay, not limiting beliefs, but limiting structure. That was my only idea. But then how do I write a blog post? I don't know how it's going to turn out. I don't feel like doing it. I didn't feel like doing it this morning. And then I realized, oh, that's creative discomfort. Some people call it resistance, creative resistance, the resistance. Oh, there it is. Oh, yeah, that's normal. It's normal to not know what to write, but then I just have to make myself start writing anything that comes to mind. Oh, what can I say about this? Oh, okay, I could say that, yeah. But what about this? Oh, can I say that? Let me just type, and let me just see what comes out. Let me just keep going. And so you have to practice activity in spite of creative discomfort. And as you keep going and as I start writing, I'm like, oh, there's a few ideas here. Okay, let me organize the ideas. Oh, well, now that I've organized the ideas, let me say more about this one and then this one and then this one. You know, let me just say, well, what might someone be thinking about this? What might someone be asking? What do I have any experiences about this I can mention? You know, I just kind of start writing from there, and then now I have a whole blog post, 800 word blog post. I'm going to share with you as a part of this video later after I finish writing it. So you see what I mean? The creative discomfort happens to me every day, but it happens in the beginning stage of creating something. And then you force yourself to keep activity, keep going, keep going, keep going. And then it just starts flowing. I'm like, oh, now the blog post is written. How did it happen? There's another quote that I like. It's impossible until it's done. Something seems impossible, like how, I don't know how this is going to create it, until you do the activity and make yourself do it, even in the spite of self-doubt, in spite of fear. Just ignore those, ignore self-doubt, ignore fear, just keep going, keep typing, keep speaking, keep brainstorming, keep writing, keep doing stuff until you get into flow. And then once you get into flow, you realize, oh, I could do this after all. Every day, do not escape creative discomfort. Creative discomfort will make you want to say, well, maybe I'm not meant to do this, right? Oh, I don't feel like doing it. Maybe I'm not meant to do this. Let me go and check email. Let me go and help somebody. It's easier to help somebody else than it is to create something for yourself. So I hope this is helpful, keeping it to within 10 minutes so I can upload this to IGTV as well. And I'll have a blog post associated with this. Last thing to say is I have a course coming up, Joyful Productivity Course, where I'll go in depth into all of this. 6 sessions, 1 hour each session. I cover a lot more. We do exercises, so I hope you join me for that as well. All right, be well. Thanks for joining me for this video. Take care.